Hi, I'm here with Rehan Zaki. He's a principal architect with Fujitsu Network Communications, and we're talking about the future of data centers and data center interconnect. Welcome.
Thank you. Good to be here, Sterling.
It's exciting space, the data centers and the evolution, a lot going on. Before we get into the technologies, let's talk a little bit about, you know, what Fujitsu is seeing in terms of this whole trend of data center architectures and really even business evolution and the entrance of edge computing.
Absolutely.
What are you seeing?
Yeah, I mean, as you said, it's a very exciting time to be in the space. From a Fujitsu perspective, we're seeing data centers evolve to support just massive amounts of bandwidth, being driven by things like 5G, IoT, content delivery networks, as well as cloud services, things like infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, being driven by the large cloud infrastructure providers, folks like Azure, folks like GCP. And so we see data centers evolving to support this massive bandwidth, but in addition to that, some of the requirements for these services are really driving data centers to evolve closer and closer to the edge. Right, so closer to the user, fundamentally changing the architecture to support high bandwidth, low latency services. From our perspective, what that's driving is the ability for a single data center to be distributed into multiple ones. And when that happens, you essentially drive the number of interconnects. Right, that's the exciting piece for us, is how do we help operators enable the extra bandwidth, how do they automate that, and how do we help reduce the complexity in that?
Exactly. One thing, when cloud came out, and it continues now as you move to distributed, the data center is an island without the connectivity between them, probably exponentially magnified with the edge. From the looking at the interconnectivity, what would you say are the biggest technical challenges that you're encountering?
That's a great question. Absolutely. So from our perspective, we see three main challenges. One is around high capacity demand from the services that I'd mentioned before, right? 5G, IoT, content delivery networks, and cloud services. The second is the ability to integrate these next generation platforms that are entering the industry right now. How to integrate these into the operator's environment? How do we standardize these? And the third is simply around time to market for services. And that is really enabled through automation.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. So automation is a good point. We have the challenges. What are the technology enablers? I imagine automation might be one of them. But how do operators solve these
Absolutely.
Problems?
So the capacity challenge, it's really pushing, physics to its limits, right? It's enabling high bandwidth traffic through integrated coherent optics, mm-hmm. right? So we're transitioning from 100 gig, 200 gig interfaces between data centers to looking at 400 gig and 600 gig today, and that's going to continue to evolve over time. The second way we're doing this is through enabling open interfaces on platforms and solutions, right? So there's a standard way to interact with a multi-vendor environment that is essentially easier for the operator to integrate into their network. And last but not least, being able to create an environment where things are automated, right? Things like A to Z provisioning, end-to-end management and orchestration are really enabled by sophisticated control and management tools that vendors like Fujitsu are building.
Okay, interesting. So as you look beyond technologies, what are the different requirements? What are operators asking you to do?
One of the key things that operators, specifically data center operators, are struggling with these days is power footprint, right? How to reduce the footprint of solutions that are being brought to them from vendors. And so I think that is a key element that we are working on, making things highly integrated to reduce the operational and power footprints of devices and solutions. And the other thing is around data analytics. How can we provide additional metrics, things like telemetry streaming from our platforms to enable a more proactive network versus a static, reactive network for our customers?
Okay. Great, interesting discussion, lots to do there. So maybe just to summarize, the message, the key message to operators from Fujitsu, what should they walk away with around data center evolution?
Fujitsu is committed to the data center interconnect market, and essentially we are bringing to market solutions that are open, scalable, and automated. And these are done by combining a few different solutions together, things like high-capacity transponders, flexible line systems, as well as a sophisticated control and management platform for the market. And we believe this will essentially help with the challenges that we discussed earlier from a market perspective.
It really is about the combination of the hardware and the software.
It is both,
not one or the other. Great. Well, as they say, it's going to be an interesting journey going forward. So wish you well and look forward to tracking your progress.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it. All right, good talking with you.